In this video, we'll see additional examples of these ideas of using the Sylow theorems to prove that groups of certain order have to have certain kinds of normal subgroups. So let's suppose that P and Q are distinct primes, and G is a group of order P squared times Q. We're going to prove that either NP equals 1 or NQ equals 1. So G must either have a normal Sylow P subgroup or a normal Sylow Q subgroup, or maybe both. So just to say where we are, P squared Q, we've been thinking about this case now quite a bit. If P is equal to 2 and Q is equal to 3, this is 12. We've talked about groups of order 12 already. And then also, if P is equal to 3 and Q is equal to 5, then we're talking about groups of order 45, which we have already talked about quite a bit. So let's prove this in two cases, depending on the relative size of P and Q. So first, suppose P is bigger than Q. And look at NP. So by Sylow 3, NP is congruent to 1 mod P, and NP divides Q. So Q is prime, so NP is 1, or it's Q. But if it's Q, then Q is congruent to 1 mod P, and that means P divides Q minus 1. But since P is bigger than Q, certainly P doesn't divide Q minus 1. So what does that mean? That means that NP equals Q is not possible. So we conclude that NP must be equal to 1, and that's what we were trying to prove. So the second case is more interesting. Let's suppose that P is smaller than Q. So what do we know? Let's look at NQ. If you look at NP, you sort of end up back in the same place, but now P might divide Q minus 1, and then we won't know what to say. Okay, so let's look at NQ. So NQ is congruent to 1 mod Q, and NQ divides P squared. So P is a prime, so NQ equals 1 or P squared. If it's 1, then we've proven the thing we're trying to prove. So let's go through the other two cases. So if NQ is equal to P, then Q divides P minus 1, because you subtract over here. So P minus 1 is 0 mod Q, and Q divides P minus 1. But that's not possible, because we know that Q is bigger than P. So Q doesn't divide P minus 1. It's just like what happened up here. So so if NQ is not equal to 1, it has to be equal to P squared. And that means P squared is congruent to 1 mod Q. So Q divides P squared minus 1. But P squared minus 1 factors nicely as P minus 1 times P plus 1. So if a prime number divides a product of these two things, it divides one of those two things. So it divides one, or it divides the other. You know that Q doesn't divide P minus 1. We just said that. It's because Q is bigger than P. So what does that mean? We have to have Q divides P plus 1. But if Q is a prime that's bigger than P, and it divides P plus 1, the only way for that to happen is now P plus 1 has to be at least as big as Q, but that means that Q has to be equal to P plus 1. So the only time that can happen for two primes is if P equals 2 and Q equals 3. But okay, that can happen, right? That checks here, that's fine. But then G is a group of order 2 squared times 3, which is 12. So now G is a group of order 12. And we're back in this previous case that we've already talked about, where we've seen that either N2 equals 1 or N3 equals 1. So there's one case of this argument that's very special that forces P equals 2 and Q equals 3. And now we're back in a case we've already considered. Okay. So as a summary, what have we seen? If P is less than Q and G is a group of order P squared times Q, then NQ equals 1, except NQ could be equal to P squared in the one case that P equals 2 and Q equals 3. But in that case, we've proven something stronger. Not only is N2 equal to 1, but G must be isomorphic to A4. So I'm going to pause and erase and we'll see one more application of this kind of reasoning. The next thing we want to prove is about groups of order 24. So let's suppose G is a group of order 24. And we want to show that G has a normal subgroup of order 4, or G has a normal subgroup of order 8. So the biggest power of 2 dividing 24 is 8. So this is a good hint that we should look at Sylow 2 subgroups. So what do we know about the number of such things? N2 is congruent to 1 mod 2, and N2 divides 3. So N2 is 1 or it's 3. If N2 is 1, then G has a normal subgroup of order 8, and we're done. So we can suppose that N2 is equal to 3. But now it's still not so clear what to do. So let's suppose that N2 equals 3. And let's pick some Sylow 2 subgroup of G and call it P. Now the idea here is clever, that we're going to prove this with a certain group action. And that's going to give us a homomorphism from G to somewhere. And our normal subgroup is going to come from the kernel. So this idea seems kind of tricky at first, but this is a pretty common way to use the Sylow theorems to prove these kinds of statements about the existence of normal subgroups. All right, so where does our group action come from? Let's consider the action of G by left multiplication on the set of left cosets of P in G. P has size 8, G has size 24, so there's 3 of these things. So what does that give us? It gives us a homomorphism from G to the symmetric group on these 3 left cosets. But that's isomorphic to S3, because the symmetric group on any 3 things is isomorphic to S3. And now a big idea is going to be to look at the kernel of this homomorphism. So let's understand what this kernel is. If X is in the kernel, what does that mean? Well, that means that the action of X on the left coset GP gives back the left coset GP for all 3 of these left cosets. So in particular, if you take the left coset of P that is just P itself, we get that the left coset of P containing X is P. So X has to be in P. So that doesn't tell you exactly what the kernel is, but it certainly says that the kernel is contained in P, that it's a subgroup of P. So that tells us something because Lagrange's theorem says now the size of the kernel divides the size of P. What else do we know? Well, first isomorphism theorem says that G mod the kernel is isomorphic to a subgroup of S3. So that means the order of this quotient, G mod K, which is the order of G divided by the order of K, 24 over the order of K, divides 6. So the order of K can't be too small. It can't be 1, 2, or 3, because then you get some number that doesn't divide 6. So what do we have? We have that the size of K is a number that divides 8, and it's not 1, 2, or 3. So what is it? It's either 4 or it's 8. And now, either way, if it's 4, you get a normal subgroup of order 4. If it's 8, you get a normal subgroup of order 8. Where is this normal subgroup coming from? It's the kernel of this homomorphism that comes from this group action, G acting by left multiplication on the set of left cosets of 1 Sylow P subgroup, Sylow 2 subgroup in the whole group. So again, this idea seems tricky at first, but it's worth getting comfortable with it because this kind of thing comes up again and again.